Hi, and welcome to Trading Star Galactica. Happy holidays, everyone. We're well into the swing of it now, and the New Year's fast approaching, so I know that a lot of people will be celebrating in one way or the other. This week's topic is set by Diana. We were all trying to come up with topic suggestions for over the Christmas period, and she chose one of my suggestions. The topic is, what are your top tips for saving money this holiday, and will you be making your own gifts or cards? Did you opt out of the whole consumer thing? And if you are making anything by hand, please show us what you've made. Quite a few of my friends this year have opted out of Christmas altogether, in that they haven't celebrated it. They've had kind of like alternative celebrations where they've just completely ignored it. And one of my friends actually went abroad to a country that doesn't even celebrate Christmas at all. They went over to Morocco, and so that they could just ignore it completely. So whereas some friends of mine have celebrated it. So my kind of immediate community around me are treating it in many different ways. As you know, my mother's been in and out of hospital. The way I celebrated Christmas Eve and Christmas Day this year was by spending it with my mother in hospital. She was discharged, but then had to go right back in again because she took a bit of a turn for the worse. So I spent Christmas Day in the hospital with my mum, and it was lovely to be with her. I don't think she really knows it's Christmas, but she loved me being there, and we had a really nice time, and the staff were wonderful. It was a really good day, and I ended up eating just like a salad and some jelly. So it's for Christmas, my Christmas lunch. And I thought, that really, you know, that's frugal. Definitely save money there. But seriously though, it is interesting. One of my top tips for saving money at Christmas is, don't buy as much food. I think we get kind of confused at Christmas, or an anxiety that the shops will be closed, or we won't have enough food. But actually, statistically, we throw away tons of food every year. One of my top tips is to really think about it and think, actually, maybe I don't need that much. If you do have a lot of leftover food, please don't throw it away. Please give it to your local homeless shelter, or in the UK now we have quite a few charities where people are just handing out food to people, because there's a lot of families on the poverty line now and that need food handouts this time of year, so who just can't make it to the end of the week, especially families with children, and they're just not being able to feed them. So don't throw your food away, give them to charities. I'll see if I can add a link at the end of this video if you are more interested in doing that. What else can we do? One thing I do is I make Christmas cards. I think it's kind of a personal touch. It's great fun. Obviously, you need a little bit of time to do that. This year, I really didn't do anything because I was just focusing on kind of being there for my mother. But quite often, that's what I'll do, is I'll make a bit of time, get some cards, use some different colour pens like gold and silver, and just kind of a fine tipped pen like this that's got a really fine tip for doing kind of cartoony sort of drawings. Other things I like to draw are birds, or robins, or kind of seasonal things, ants, mice, just little creatures that exist, bugs, and various things like that. People who've had cards from me will know this already. I'm actually at my mother's house at the moment, and I don't have any photographs to show you, but I think I can get hold of some in the next few weeks, and I'll add them to one of my videos anyway, so you can understand what I'm talking about, because it probably sounds quite strange. But it's true, I can make an ant look festive Yes. And that's fun as well, and people like it, and they don't have to be perfect. They can just be kind of sketchy, and that, you know, that in itself is fun and funny, and I think people appreciate that you've taken the effort to do that. One of the things that we've done in my family, and also I know quite a few people have done it, just because it seems wasteful in a way, giving gifts sometimes that perhaps people don't need, or just for the sake of it because it's Christmas. So we had a rule that we would just give presents to children, and as adults, you know, we wouldn't be giving each other gifts, because it just, you know, it gets to a stage as well, I think, where you don't really need more and more objects. So we save it for when it's each other's birthdays, and then we'll give gifts, really quite personal gifts to each other. But if it's Christmas, we'll just give presents to children. It's coming up to the new year. I know that's a time in the UK where traditionally people get completely slaughtered, and that's slang for very, very drunk. For all those people in different countries who don't know what that means. Probably people could save a lot of money, I imagine, if they maybe didn't get quite as drunk. I think it's a difficult time, and I think we're all trying to find ways to have a good time and to let our hair down and to relax a little bit, but also we've all got... the majority of us have financial considerations more than normal, simply because of the recession that we're in, and but there are so many things that you can do and good feelings that you can get from not spending money, but from spending time with people and friends and family, and from connecting with people. And Jen made a wonderful video, a very funny video as well, but she's right, a phone call where you connect with someone is a wonderful thing in itself, and it's a wonderful gift. Or even messaging or Skyping with people. Not everything we do has to cost us money. I think in an increasingly secular society as well, many people are opting out and choosing to do something different rather than celebrate Christmas as such, and that's interesting to me. So if you've done that, or if you celebrated a pagan festival instead, please do let me know. I'd love to hear. I'm going to put some links to the food charities and homeless shelter charities in the UK at the end of this video. If you know of charities in the regions that you live in the countries that you live in, please do add them to this video, and then we can use it as a resource for other people who wish to support those charities. So yeah, so please do add those links in the comments below. That would be wonderful. Thank you. Please do share your answers to our topic question this week too. I'd absolutely love to hear. Also, hoping that you're all having a very good week, and wishing you a very happy and safe New Year. See you next Tuesday. Bye.